Okay, today we're going to talk about Lambda permissions and security. So you got a Lambda function and you need to manage it or you need to execute it as either a user or a role. How are you going to do that? Other questions that we need to answer? How are we going to execute that Lambda function from another AWS service? For example, from EventBridge or from SQS or SNS. So different answers depending on where we're originating those from. So for a user or a role, you would attach IAM policies directly to that user, to a group the user is in, or for a role, directly to the role or to a policy, a managed policy, which then gets attached to the role. All of this is covered in the IAM section. So if you're not clear on this, worth going and have a look at those tutorials. If you want to execute the Lambda function from another AWS service, which is an extremely common pattern, you know, you might have an event bridge rule. For example, you get a guard duty alert, you want to have a Lambda function that posts a message on Slack to let people know that there's a potential security problem. You would set up a Lambda resource policy, and on that resource policy, you would say that you allow invocation from EventBridge. Same is true of SNS, SQS, any other AWS service. So the next thing you might be wondering is, okay, what if that Lambda function then needs permissions of its own? For example, it needs to write stuff into an S3 bucket, or it needs to write logs into CloudWatch logs, because that's where all Lambda functions would log their output. Or maybe you need to trigger other Lambda functions from within the Lambda function. So there we do not use the resource policy. The resource policy is about inbound things invoking the Lambda. There, what we shouldn't do is use access keys, which are long-lived credentials that are used for users. The main reason we wouldn't want to use these is because they're long-lived. If they leak, then it will look like your Lambda function is doing things that actually someone that has obtained those credentials is doing. So it's quite common for AWS accounts that have leaked access keys to have machines spun up that are doing crypto mining, that kind of thing, running up a very big bill and causing a big headache. So don't do that. Don't create access keys for your Lambda function. Instead, what you do is you attach a Lambda execution role. And this is another role that is used by your Lambda function to give it the appropriate permissions. If you're using CDK, this will be created for you. AWS have a service called AWS SAM, which is used for creating serverless workflows. That will also create the Lambda execution role and assign appropriate permissions for you. You can, of course, do it manually as well. So that will obviously allow you to log things and it will also allow you to do whatever else you need. Until next time, enjoy the cloud.